All right, welcome back inside our Vancouver Proactive Studios and welcome in the CEO of Minaurum Gold, Darrell Rader. Darrell, great to meet you. How are you doing?
Thank you, Steve. Thanks for having me. Appreciate being here.
Yeah, pretty interesting story. An exploration company with work in Mexico. So give us sort of a quick background on the company.
Sure. About 10 years ago, we put together Minaurum. The idea behind Minaurum was to pursue large district scale projects. So for the first time, we put together a group of basically mine finders in Mexico, individuals such as Dr. Peter McGaw, who discovered one of the largest silver discoveries in Mexico in the last 20 years, David Jones, who discovered one of the largest gold mines in Mexico. And for the first time, we put them on a team and decided to go out and look for very large deposits. And so we built a pipeline, and basically over the years, we've been going one by one through these projects and drilling them off.
That's pretty unique for a company when you consider the talent level that you have working with yourself and on the management team. Is that something that was by design right away? We wanted to make sure that we could find the best talent to do exactly what we wanted.
Yeah, definitely. It came out of a number of the financial backers having this idea of consolidating this talent in a single vehicle. And that's where Minaurum came from. And, that talent has helped us survive the bear market and accumulate a position of projects and accumulate most notably our Alamos Silver Project where we're working now.
Yeah.
And it's the old adage goes in this industry, you follow the team that's been successful in the past. And that's what investors are thankfully doing, and we're using that to our advantage.
Let's talk about Alamos. Give me an idea about what you love about this project.
You know, Alamos has a pretty fascinating history. If you go back hundreds of years, there was a silver district called the Alamos Silver District, of which we control the vast majority. It was one of the highest grade silver producers in all of Mexico. It built the town of Alamos. Alamos ended up being home to one of the only mints outside of Mexico City due to the purity of the silver. And what happened is over the years, this project ended up staying sort of, I call it a bit of like a patchwork quilt, is you had dozens of property owners, dozens of little claims, some encompassing these old mines. And these old mines had produced over 200 million ounces of silver, of high grade silver.
Okay.
And what had happened was over the years, that sort of kept large companies from coming in because they can never build a critical mass of claims. So about 8 years ago, a Mexican family that's been very successful in the mining field took the time to basically consolidate this, spent millions of dollars, well over 5 years, consolidating this into a cohesive package. And then based on our track record in Mexico, came and approached Minaurum and said, guys, would you explore this thing? And so we're now conducting the first systematic exploration program over the entire district for the first time, all consolidated.
Wow. And so you have a chance to own 100% of that project?
Correct. We have an option to own 100%, and we're well on our way with the amount of money we're spending on the ground.
So tell us what's been done on the project so far and what you're planning on doing.
So we take a bit of a different approach with this explorationist team we have. We're focused on new discoveries. So the temptation for juniors is often to go in a historic mine and look for stuff that's been left behind. You don't want to get too aggressive because you may step out and then there's nothing there.
Right.
And we took the approach to basically look for new veins in the district and almost completely ignore the historic vein. And what ended up happening pretty quickly was we discovered that there were all these neighboring veins that had never been mined. Our geological team put together a model that basically said what we're seeing is we're seeing areas where veins have been pushed up and some veins have been pushed down.
Okay.
And the ones that were pushed up had high grade on surface. The Spaniards found it, mined it, and built these large mines. Mm-hmm. Now with the neighboring veins, they've been pushed down. So what you see on surface is sort of the tops of these systems, which is kind of lowish grade, the veins a bit sporadic, and that's why it wasn't mined. So about 2 years ago, we decided it's time to do proof of concept. We went in and drilled, and basically on our seventh hole, we proved that concept, and we drilled into one of these blocks that had been dropped down. And the first thing we discovered was these little wispy veins on surface, 200-300 meters down, were bonanza grade over, wide widths. For instance, our highlight hole was 1,700 grams of silver over 8 meters, along with a bunch of base metals. And
wow.
This is from a vein that 300 meters on surface, higher up, vertical height, is a 1 to 2 meter wide, grading a couple hundred grams.
Mm.
So that proved the model, and since then we've just continued to aggressively drill these new veins, and we're still finding new veins, I'd say on the average about one every 6 to 8 weeks. And the idea is to go in and drill all of these, and only once you've built like an inventory of veins is to go back and prioritize and actually start drilling off them one by one.
Will that be your focus for the bulk of 2019 then?
Correct. Yeah. So the focus of 2019 is to go and continue doing this process. We foresee probably continuing till about July, August of this year. Mind you, if we keep discovering new veins, we'll keep continuing it. But at that point, we sort of discussed internally, maybe that's a time where you start going back and following up on some of the discovery holes we've made. But at this point, these discovery holes, like the one I mentioned to you, we haven't even drilled within a kilometer and a half of it since.
Oh, okay.
And not only we haven't drilled within a kilometer and a half of it, we also haven't drilled the same vein anymore. So we're really aggressively building an inventory here.
So you mentioned, Darrell, that Minaurum is a bit of a different company. And one of the other differences for junior mining companies is you have a large treasury, which is very rare in the business, over almost $10 million.
Correct. Yeah, we're almost at $10 million. The one thing I credit to that is naturally both our shareholder base, but also the team we built at Minaurum. You know, I've sort of given you their backgrounds, but in my view, it's really an unparalleled team in the junior industry. You know, the odds are that most geologists will never find a deposit in their career. And when you get multiple geologists that all discovered major deposits and put them on the same team here, we're starting to see that success in Alamos. And even more notably, the industry in general is looking for new discoveries, but it's this catch-22 where when the market's bad, nobody's going to finance new discoveries, so you can't raise money to drill them, but you're expected to find them in order to access capital.
Right.
So thankfully, our team got the capital, and through getting this money in a bad market, we found the silver project, and we were able to go in right away and start drilling this thing aggressively. So that's basically the plan for 2019, is to keep exploring this thing systematically.
Well, it's fascinating for sure, and it's going well so far, so congratulations, and we look
forward to
hearing more about the story as it continues. Great to meet you.
Excellent. Thank you, Steve.
Yeah, that's Darrell Rader. He's the president and CEO of Minaurum Gold.